Welcome to worship with Grace Church. I'm Pastor Rory Swenson. And we are back to school. We are continuing with our Jesus lessons, Jesus Lessons 101. And we're going to talk about bread today. What does Jesus teach you about bread? And with that, we're also celebrating World Communion Sunday. So you are invited to have some kind of bread and some juice for you to use as the church at home when we come to that time of communion. Do you think there's also a lesson in the communion bread? Jesus actually used bread as a lesson time and time again. He fed a hungry crowd with bread enough for all. Think of all those meals with so-called tax collectors and sinners. He was breaking bread with them. There was bread on the table. Jesus in John's Gospel says, "I am the bread of life." And of course, in the sacrament of communion, we share Jesus and his promises and his life by sharing the bread. We share the blessings of forgiveness and reconciliation and belonging. We share a table of community with bread. Bread reminds us of the Jesus way to live, a way that is blessed and broken, given, shared. I think we need that kind of bread in the world today. Let's join responsibly in the call to worship. God of parables and praise, in Jesus Christ, we worship you. You teach us with stories and lead us with lessons. You show us mustard seeds and bread, children, neighbors, and needs around us. The wisdom of your words calls us to compassion and service, to prayer and healing. God of parables and praise, in Jesus Christ, we worship you. You know, Marilyn Oliphant was thinking of this beautiful autumn season, and she had asked that we sing, "This is my Father's world," to remind us of this beauty. So sing along as you hear our singers, "This is my Father's world."
Sweet.
Join me in this prayer for guidance. There is a hungry crowd in me, O God. I am hungry for the food of faith. I am starving for love, craving truth, and searching for hope. I have filled myself with things that do not satisfy me, and I pray in my longing soul. I pray for peace and healing in the compassion you give to me. In Christ, my bread, I pray. Amen. Hello, all of you young friends. I am with Theo and the kangaroos, and I'm with you. And I'm going to talk about something special that we are doing today. We are having communion, and a special kind of communion. But communion's kind of a big word, isn't it? It's a word that means sharing. And usually for communion, we have some bread, and we share some bread. It could be any kind of bread. And we have a cup. And these are things that Jesus did with his disciples long ago. He shared bread and he shared a cup. And it was a way of sharing that we remember Jesus and God's love. But this is also special today because it's World Communion Sunday. That's like saying we are sharing with everybody in the world because God loves the whole world. So this is a day when I am also getting this globe out and I'm thinking of how God's love is for everybody in the world. Do you have a globe at home? If you do, it's kind of fun to just get out the globe and give it a spin and shut my eyes and let my hand see where it stops. Oh, I stopped up in Canada. God loves all the people in Canada, and I pray for all the people in Canada. I'll do another one. See what I get. Ooh, okay, I'm out in the middle of the ocean. Must be for all the people who are out on ships and boats and people flying, and all those people God loves. But I could go around and I could remember, oh, God loves all the people in Russia, and God loves all the people in China and India. Oh, let's see. Here, I think I'll pick, Liberia and Sierra Leone and Guinea and Cote d'Ivory and Ghana and the Cameroon and Saudi Arabia and Egypt, and I want to find Somalia. You know what? God loves everybody in all these places. Oh, kangaroo says make sure we get to Australia. Where's Australia? Ah. Okay, kangaroo, we got Australia too. God loves everybody in Australia. And God loves all those people, so we are sharing love with them too. And we do that by hoping everything is good for all those people in all those places, because that is how we share God's love. So communion is sharing. And the bread and the cup remind us to share with everybody, because that's what Jesus does for us. Let's pray. Dear God, we love the whole world. And so let us care for the whole world as well. Give us big hearts to do that the way you love everybody. In Jesus' name, amen.
Please. The scripture today comes from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 15, verses 32 through 39 in the New Revised Standard Version. Then Jesus called his disciples to him and said, "I have compassion for the crowd because they have been with me now for 3 days and have nothing to eat, and I do not want to send them away hungry, for they might faint on the way." The disciples said to him, "Where are we going to get enough bread in the desert to feed so great a crowd?" Jesus asked them, "How many loaves have you?" They said, "Seven and a few small fish." Then ordering the crowd to sit down on the ground, he took the 7 loaves and the fish, and after giving thanks, he broke them and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And all of them ate and were filled, and they took up the broken pieces left over, 7 baskets full. Those who had eaten were 4,000 men, besides women and children. After sending away the crowds, he got into the boat and went to the region of Magadan. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
What is the lesson in that story of feeding a multitude that James read for us today? 5,000, 4,000 in this case, plus women and children. But remember, it starts with Jesus seeing the crowd, having compassion on them, knows that they are hungry. They need food. And what do they have? Well, it starts with a few loaves and some fish being shared. And that is put into Jesus' hands. And he thanks God. He blesses that bread and he shares it. And there is even more. Let's pray. Dear God, once again, let these scriptures find their way out of the past as just something long ago, but a living wisdom speaking to us today. Let those pages printed on paper, let them come alive and speak to us. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, I'm going to come at this with a story. You know, Jesus used stories too, and for Jesus Lessons 101, that would be a whole another message for another day. But this is an Appalachian style of story, and my version goes back to Michael Williams. Michael Williams was a United Methodist pastor in Tennessee who was famous for his story style of sermons. So, credit to him. It's a very simple story. Just enjoy the simplicity. Don't overthink it. Once upon a time, there was a widow woman, and she had 3 daughters. And she had a hard time supporting those 3 daughters all by herself. So one day, the oldest daughter said, "Mama, I just got to get off on my own. I got to make my own life. I got to go find my fortune." "Well, that's fine," said the mother. So she made a little something for her daughter to take along. Something for her to eat. So she made some Johnny cake. Now, Johnny cake is really not cake at all. Actually, it's bread. It's a kind of a flat bread, and it's not named for anybody named Johnny. It's from the word journey. It's journey cake. It was originally bread for the journey, okay? Well, anyway, the mother made 2 loaves of this Johnny cake, and she said to her daughter, "Now, darling, I want to ask you something. When you go, would you rather have a whole loaf of bread, but without my blessing, or would you rather have a half loaf, but with my blessing?" Well, the oldest daughter thought, "I might have to travel a long way before I find my fortune. And really, what good is a blessing if I'm starving to death? So I'll take the whole loaf. Thank you very much." Mama gave her the whole loaf, and she was on her way. Well, after a while, it was time to eat, and as she was eating, the birds came, and they sat in the trees around her. Rabbits, squirrels, raccoons came and sat by her feet. And all these forest animals looked at her with hungry eyes, But she just stared back and said, get out of here, scram! I don't have enough Johnny cake to feed you. I've got just enough for myself, so go on, get! So they scattered off, they left. Well, finally, as she traveled around, she went and found a way to make her fortune. She came to the house of a woman who needed someone to stay up all night and watch the fire in her fireplace. You see, her fire kept going out, and the house kept getting cold. And so the woman said, I'll make you a deal. If you can stay up all night, every night for a week, and keep my fire going without falling asleep and letting my house get cold, I'll give you a basket of gold, a basket of silver, and a bottle of liniment that if you rub it on a dead person, it'll bring them back to life. All right, that sounded like a pretty good deal and pretty good stuff, every bit of it. So she said, that's good, it is a deal. First night came. The old woman went to bed. And you know, it was easy to stay up and watch that fire. But then the fire began to die, and the room got darker and quieter. And in the early morning, she dozed off, and she fell asleep. Well, that old woman got up in the morning, and the house was cold, and the fire was out, and that girl was sound asleep. And she was so angry, she hollered at that girl and started to chase her and hit her with a walking stick. And, well, the thing is, she caught that girl and hit her on the head so hard that, well, it killed her. Oh, Lordy, what am I going to do? I got to hide this body. And so the old woman dragged the body down the road and off to a pile of weeds. Not long after that, the second sister came to her mother and said, Mama, my older sister hasn't come back. She must be doing pretty good. So I guess I should go out and find my fortune too. The mother did just what she did before, made up two loaves of Johnny cake, two loaves of that journey bread. Okay, daughter, which loaf do you want? The whole loaf, but without my blessing, or the half loaf, but with my blessing? Now, the second daughter was also very smart, not quite as smart as the eldest daughter, but pretty smart. And she thought, you know, it might take me a while to find a job and get my fortune, and I might get hungry. And, you know, what good is a blessing when you're hungry? I'm going to need that whole loaf. Thank you very much. Well, wouldn't you know it, the second daughter went through the same woods, went to the same house with the same woman, and got the very same job. Stay up every night for a week, don't go to sleep, and let my fire go out, and I'll give you a basket of gold, a basket of silver, and a bottle of liniment. Then if you rub it on a dead person, it'll bring them back to life. First night came. The old woman went to bed, and the second daughter said, ah, this will be so easy. She built up a big fire, and then she very quietly started to hum and sing songs to herself to keep herself awake. Well, she hummed and she sang. She hummed and she sang. She hummed and she sang and hummed and... Well, instead of keeping herself awake, guess what happened? She hummed herself sound asleep. Next morning, that woman got up and she was furious. The house was cold, the fire was out, and she started beating on that girl with a walking stick and hit her so hard. Well, yeah, it happened again. Oh, Lord, I got to stop doing this, but good help is so hard to find. Better hide the evidence. So another body got rolled off to the weed patch. Well, as you might figure out, it was time for the youngest daughter. There is a little predictability to this story. Mama, I don't know what happened to my sisters, but I think I better go looking for them. Now, you see, this girl was not as smart as her sisters. In fact, she was kind of simple, or maybe she had a deeper kind of innocence. So her mother said, I'll get you ready for the journey. Mother did the same thing, made up two Johnny cakes, two loaves of journey bread. Darling, what do you want? A whole loaf, but without my blessing, or a half loaf with my blessing? Now, that youngest daughter was not smart enough to think about how long the journey might be and how long it might take to find her sisters. So she said, "Oh, Mama, I couldn't think of going anywhere without your blessing. I'll take the half loaf, and it'll be plenty for me. It's all I need." And so the mother broke the bread, offered a blessing, and she gave it to her simple, loving daughter, and off she went. Well, she stopped along the way, and the birds and the animals came and stood round her, and she said, "Oh, look at you, aren't you so pretty?" She wasn't smart enough to be afraid. She just said, "Aren't you pretty? I'll bet you're hungry." So she started crumbling up that bread. She was throwing it to the birds, feeding the squirrels and the raccoons, just all of them. And they ate. They all had enough. And that was fine. She went on her way. Now it just so happened that she found that same old house and the same old woman and got the very same job that her sisters had. Isn't it amazing how that works out? And that woman said, "I'll make you a deal. If you can stay up all night for a whole week and keep my fire going, I'll give you a basket of gold, a basket of silver, and a bottle of liniment that if you rub it on a dead person, it'll bring them back to life." And that little girl thought, goodness, I don't need any gold. I don't need any silver, but that bottle of liniment, I never heard of such a thing. That might be handy. So the first night she sat by the fire and the old woman went to bed. And that girl started to get sleepy. And sleepy. Sleepy. Oh, she was tired. You know, she'd been walking all day. And pretty soon she dozed off. But just then the birds started singing at the window. And it woke her right up. They were the same birds that she had seen out in the woods. So she stayed up a little bit longer. Oh, but her eyes got heavy and she started to nod off. And, well, just then there was a scratching and knocking at the door. And she went to the door and it was those little forest friends. Rabbits, squirrels, raccoons. And by the time she let them in and out and, well, talking to the animals, she was wide awake. And she stayed awake for the rest of the night. Well, when the woman got up, nice warm fire, and she was pleased, and she said, "Oh, you're going to do just fine. Let me see how you do for 6 more nights." 6 nights came and went, and every time the youngest daughter started to fall asleep, the birds came, the animals came, and they got her through the night. At the end of the week, the woman said, "I keep my word. Here's a basket full of gold and a basket full of silver and a bottle of liniment that if you rub it on dead people, it'll bring them back to life." And the girl said, "Well, you know, I think I will take that gold and that silver because I think my mama needs it. But I'm really worried about my 2 older sisters. They left a long time ago and I'm afraid they might be dead. I might need that bottle of liniment." Now, of course, that old woman figured out now who this sister was. And she said, "You know, there were 2 sisters who came by here a while back, but, oh, I don't know where they went. Down the road, I guess. But it's full of robbers and thieves, and it's dangerous. And you might find them over in that patch of weeds, you know. Down that way. Maybe. You might want to just go look over there." This girl was so simple and so trusting, she didn't suspect a thing. But sure enough, out in the weeds, she found her sisters, and she put that liniment all over them. And yes, they came back to life. And they all went home, and they shared in the gold and the silver, and they all ate Johnny cake and lived happily ever after. Diane. Well, maybe not really the end, but... So why am I telling you that story? Well, the Bible says that Jesus looked with compassion at the multitude, the hungry crowd. He took bread, blessed it, and broke it. He did it again with his disciples, and he said, "Take, eat, do this in remembrance of me." He met 2 travelers on a road going to their homes in Emmaus, and when they got home, he picked up some bread and he broke it. And he was known to them in the breaking of the bread. Jesus, the Blessed One, the one who blessed us, said, "I am the bread of life." And what kind of bread is it? It is the sacred bread of compassion. It is the broken bread, the bread that is shared. Jesus took the bread and he said, "This is my body given for you, my very life given for you." See, the thing is, every day we are choosing a path for life, a step at a time. We're waiting to get bread for the journey as we go out to make our way in the world. But a question is being asked in life, again and again, decision by decision. Which bread line are you in? Those who want the whole loaf for themselves, not caring about the blessing. Or those who receive the half loaf, but with a blessing, for that blessed way of life. And I know there is so much influence and pressure telling you, telling me to keep the whole loaf for yourself. Because, well, you know, you might not have enough. But remember, please, I beg you, to remember, it's the half loaf. It's the broken loaf. It's the shared bread, the sacrificed bread, the bread of selflessness, the bread for others, the bread for generosity. That is the bread that carries the blessing and is blessing us today, and that is the bread that we see in the life of Jesus Christ. That's the Jesus bread. Get this. Communion shows us the bread of blessing, the bread of love and compassion. And your homework, your spiritual homework is this. Maybe every time you see bread, I invite you to pray. Which loaf of bread are you taking on your journey? And as you think about which bread you're living with, what is your approach to life and to others? In other words, what are you doing with the bread? By that I mean the bread of your life, your gifts, your dreams, the financial bread, yes. But the very bread of your being, the bread of your soul. Later this month, you're going to be invited to make an estimate of giving for 2021. It's an invitation to think about bread, to share with a blessing through Grace Church. I hope this pandemic is not creating that kind of bread shortage. I don't believe we have a bread shortage of faith, hope, and love, do you? The bread is there. So remember the Jesus lesson about bread. Remember that it's a bread given to us that comes with a blessing of God's love for you, in you, and through you. Let's be the people, Grace Church, let's be the people who share the bread. In the name of Jesus Christ, our bread of life. Amen.
Is life laid down for me?
Welcome to this time of prayer, all of you joining us in your homes, wherever you may be. You've already been praying as we've gone through this worship service, prayed with music, prayed through scripture, prayed by simply getting your computer or device out. But this is World Communion Sunday, as you've been hearing. And instead of having James hold the microphone, as he often does, we're going to give you something a little bigger to hold. So James, why don't you pick up that globe? On this World Communion Sunday, James, you're holding up the world as we pray for the world. I want you to think about all the places that have been on the news. You know, I a lot of times in prayers, you know, we pray for people close to us, loved ones, family, friends, folks we go around with in our daily life. And that's good. That's good. Praying for people in hospitals or through treatments or just changes in life, students, of course. But every day we're invited to remember God loves the world. So, James, just put your hand on that globe. Anywhere, just up on the top. Yeah, wherever. Yeah. And we're praying. In the name of Jesus Christ, who tells us that God so loved the world. So as we pray for the world, we're praying for those fires that continue and the destruction and loss of life that have been happening in California, Oregon, Washington, other places. Places where there's been storm, strong winds, rains, floods. Sometimes that happens in faraway places, and we hear about it in passing, and the news cycle moves on, but God, your attention stays there. Places where that COVID disease is ravaging people, and they don't have the kind of health care that we do have. Places where there are political tensions, places where there is war and violence. We pray for peace. We pray for the hungry. We pray for those who just want to rise up knowing that the next day could be a little bit better. So give hope. May there be people who carry hope in their hands with food and shelter and medicine. So we lift to you these prayers, spoken and unspoken, and all the prayers for the people who make up the world close to you. In Jesus' name, amen. I hope that you have been able to gather what you would like to use for your communion time at home. Some kind of bread, something to share in a cup. For our communion prayers, I'm going to begin with these words of Paul in 1 Corinthians. He says, "For I received from the Lord what I also handed on to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he took the cup." He took the cup also after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." And our prayers continue with this reading prayer entitled Bread and Justice. It's in our United Methodist hymnal, and it comes from Ruben Alves in Brazil. Let this be our communion prayer. O God, just as the disciples heard Christ's words of promise and began to eat the bread and drink the wine in the suffering of a long remembrance and in the joy of a hope, grant that we may hear your words spoken in each thing of everyday affairs. Coffee on our table in the morning, the simple gesture of opening a door to go out free. The shouts of children in the parks, a familiar song sung by an unfamiliar face, a friendly tree that has not yet been cut down. May simple things speak to us of your mercy and tell us that life can be good. And may these sacramental gifts make us remember those who do not receive them, those who have their lives cut every day in the bread absent from the table, in the door of the hospital, the prison, the welfare home that does not open, in sad children, feet without shoes, eyes without hope, in war hymns that glorify death, in deserts where there once was life. Christ was also sacrificed, and may we learn that we participate in the saving sacrifice of Christ when we participate in the sufferings of his little ones. God, you give us Jesus Christ. You give us these gifts to remember his way of life, his life in us. I invite you to take whatever kind of bread you have. Maybe it's a rye bread. Maybe it's a bagel. Maybe it's a rice cracker. Could be something gluten-free. Whatever you have, a wrap. Take that bread and take whatever you have for your communion cup and share that with whoever you might be gathered with, also with us in spirit as we remember the bread, blessing, the blessings of bread in the table of Jesus Christ. Share the bread, share the cup. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. We have celebrated, shared bread and cup. And on this World Communion Sunday, we're also thinking of how that sharing happens through the ministries of the church around the world. We are a part of that worldwide ministry, not only through United Methodist connections, but all the other ways in which we just partner and respond to places in need. And of course, that ministry happens right here in Burnsville and our communities here around Minnesota. So this offering is an invitation for us to continue to share the table, share the bread, share God's love. So I want to thank you for all the ways in which you continue to be people of communion, people of sharing in those offerings. Thank you. Give this offering because the table of your love has more than enough to share. The bread is still multiplied. The cup continues to overflow. The table is prepared for all to belong, So may these gifts extend the table of communion to all in Christ wherever we are. Amen.
Before we come to the benedictions, let me just share a couple of announcements. First of all of the worship services in October are at 10 o'clock, so we're starting that this Sunday, 10 a.m. rather than the 9 a.m. And then, starting October 18th, we're going to be gathering back inside. Getting a little chilly outside, so if this is a kind of worship setting that you feel comfortable and safe in, we've got pews marked off, and we'll continue to not have congregational singing. We'll use some of that recorded music, and again, do good safe practices, but we will start to gather inside on October 18th. And then also a word of thanks to our musicians today, Marilyn on the piano, Paige Macklin, our music director, our choir director, gathered up music today. So we had Paige Macklin, we had Sue Ann Turner, and we had Addie Benjamin with us. So thank you, and if you'd like to be part of that music ministry, contact Paige and she can help coordinate that. Again, thank you for being with us in worship. Blessings on your day. Benediction. Oh God, we are filled with bread of love. We've been well fed. Now let us share bread with others. The bread is the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. The bread is the love of God. The bread is the communion of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.